Let's consider the following probability problem. Six jokes about books by Groucho Marx, Bob Blitzer, Stephen Wright, Henry Youngman, Jerry Seinfeld, and Phyllis Diller are each written on one of six cards. The cards are placed in a hat and run one at a time. What is the probability that a man's joke will be delivered first and a woman's jokes last? Now, just so you know, the first five names mentioned here are names of men. And the last one, Phyllis Diller, is the only woman in the group. So we have six jokes from six people. Five of them are men and one is a woman. To compute for the probability that a man's joke will be delivered first and woman's joke will be delivered last, we will follow this given formula here. The probability is computed by dividing the number of permutation man's jokes first, woman's joke last, by the total number of possible permutations. Now let's start by computing the total number of possible permutations. To compute for the total number of possible permutations, we will not consider any restrictions at all. We are delivering six jokes. For the first joke, we will have six choices. If the first joke has already been delivered, the second joke will have five choices. The third joke will just have four choices since two were already delivered. After that, the fourth joke will only have three choices, and the fifth joke will only have two choices, and the last joke will only have one choice. Multiplying everything using the fundamental counting principle, this would result to 720 permutations. The next step is to count the number of permutations, the man's jokes first and then woman's jokes last. We will use the fundamental counting principle. We have six jokes to be delivered. The first joke should have five choices because the joke can come from any one of the five men. No restrictions for second, third, fourth, and fifth, but for the last joke, it has to come from a woman. And on the list, the only woman on the list is Phyllis Diller. So therefore, we only have one choice for the sixth joke. The rule here, if there's any restriction, you have to count first those with restriction. We have delivered two jokes already. That gives us four choices for the second joke. And for the third joke, we have three choices because three jokes were already been assigned. And then for the fourth, you have two options. And then for the fifth joke, you only have one choice. So multiplying everything, that is equal to 120. To find the probability that a man's joke will be delivered first and woman's joke last, we will just have to divide 120 by 720. 120 divided by 720 is equal to 1 over 6. Now let's consider another example. Powerball is a multi-state lottery played in most US states. It is the first lottery game to randomly draw numbers from two drums. The game is set up so that each player chooses five different numbers from 1 to 59 and one Powerball from 1 to 35. Twice per week, five white balls are randomly drawn from a drum with 59 white balls numbered from 1 to 59. And then one red Powerball is drawn randomly from a drum with 35 red balls, numbered from 1 to 35. A player wins the jackpot by matching all five numbers drawn from the white balls in any order and matching the number on the red Powerball. With one $2 Powerball ticket, what is the probability of winning the jackpot? To find the probability of winning, we will use the following formula here. The probability of winning is equal to the number of ways of winning divided by the total number of possible combinations. Because the order of the five numbers shown on the white balls does not matter, this is a situation involving combinations. Therefore, we will use combination formula. Take five balls from 59 white balls. So that is 59 taken 5. And we have 59 factorial divided by 59 minus 5 factorial times 5 factorial. 59 minus 5 is equal to 54. So you have 54 factorial times 5 factorial in the denominator, and then just copy the 59 factorial in the numerator. We will write 59 factorial as 59 times 58 times 57 times 56 times 55 times 54 factorial. And then just copy 54 factorial in the denominator and write out 5 factorial as 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. Canceling 54 factorial, you will have this divided by this. And just use your calculator to compute, you get 5,006,386. Next is to determine the number of ways of selecting the red Powerball. Because there are 35 red Powerballs in the second drum, and then we will just pick one Powerball. Therefore, that gives us 35 possible numbers to choose from. Using the fundamental counting principle, we will find the total number of possible combinations in the Powerball. That is just by multiplying the number of combinations for the white balls, that is 5 numbers from 59, times the 35 number of ways or choices from the red ball. We have computed that the combination 59 taken 5 is equal to 5,006,386. Then just multiply that to 35, you get 175,223,510. There are 175,223,510 number of combinations in Powerball. Now, if a person buys one ticket, that person has selected only one combination of numbers. Therefore, with one Powerball ticket, there is only one way of winning the jackpot. So the numerator is 1. And then divided by the total possible combinations in the Powerball, that is 175,223,510. And that is approximately equal to 5.707 times 10 to the negative 9. That is actually a very small number that is close to 0. Let's consider another example. A club consists of 5 men and 7 women. 3 members are selected at random to attend a conference. Find the probability that the selected group consists of 3 men. Look at this diagram here. We have a total of 12 club members, and that is from 5 men and 7 women that are members of the club. We want to find the probability that the 3 members selected to attend the conference are all men. It is important to take note that the order of selection here does not matter. It would not matter who is selected first, second, or third. So therefore, this problem is a problem involving combinations. To get the probability that the selected group consists of 3 men, we will use this formula here. So that is just dividing the number of ways of selecting 3 men divided by the total number of possible combinations. First, we will compute for the total number of possible combinations. We will want to know how many possible three-person selections. There should be no restriction. It could have two women, one man, or all women, as long as it has three members in the combination. We will use the combination formula. Take three from the 12 members of the club. That is just a combination, 12 taken 3, using the combination formula, that is 12 factorial divided by 12 minus 3 factorial times 3 factorial. Now 12 minus 3 is equal to 9, so this becomes 9 factorial. And then we will rewrite this 12 factorial as 12 times 11 times 10 times 9 factorial. And the 9 factorial here will just be copied, and 3 factorial will be written as 3 times 2 times 1. Then we can cancel 9 factorial here, and then we can simplify this. We get 220. So there are 220 possible three-person selections. The next step is to determine the numerator. We want to find the number of ways of selecting three men. Since we are interested in the number of ways of selecting three men, then we will just select it from the group of men. We will still use combinations because the ordering does not matter. Take combination 5 taken 3. Use the formula. Combination 5 taken 3 is equal to 5 factorial divided by 5 minus 3 factorial times 3 factorial. 5 minus 3 is equal to 2. So this is just equal to 2 factorial. 5 factorial may be rewritten as 5 times 4 times 3 factorial. And then we'll just copy this 3 factorial here and then write 2 factorial as 2 times 1. Cancel this 3 factorial. So we have 20 divided by 2, which is equal to 10. So 10 is the number of ways of selecting 3 men from 5 men members in the club. So therefore, the probability that the selected group consists of 3 men is just equal to 10 over 220, which is equal to 1 over 22.